What's up, everybody? I am your host, Joseph, and welcome to Fiction Ink Flow. This is October, so you know what that means. Villains Month! And with a lot of villains gaining popularity, such as Joker, Suicide Squad, Carnage and Venom, and Deadpool, I want to know, what makes a villain? Right? We got all these villains, but what makes the villains the best ones out there? So I'm here to give you my five traits that really make a good villain. Trait number one is that the villains are convinced that they are the good guys. They actually believe they are the heroes of the story. Take Ultron, all right? Ultron is a robot who believes that in order to achieve world peace, all humans have to die. I mean, it makes a lot of sense, since most of our conflict, wars, and environmental issues have been because of humans. So I can kind of get his point. Trait number two is that the villains are likable. When these villains come on screen, or if you read them in a book, you know you are going to be entertained and they're going to put on a show. For example, Deadpool. When he gets his time to shine, you know he's going to get laughs, action, and you're going to root for him to win. That's one of the traits that makes him such a likable character. All right, number three trait is that they are very similar to the hero, right? They have some of the same characteristics and ideas. All right, so going with one of my favorite villains is Magneto from the X-Men, all right? He's a mutant, and he feels that all mutants are superior to humans because of their powers and abilities. His arch nemesis, Professor X, believes that humans and mutants should work together to build a better society. But Magneto's like, nah, I don't believe in all that. We're smarter, we're better, so we know what to do. So all humans should just sit back and let them lead, and you just follow whatever they say. Trait number four is that they stop at absolutely nothing to achieve their goal. This leads me to the mad titan himself, Thanos, right? It gets no better than that. Think about it. From the Infinity Gauntlet book, as well as the Infinity War and Endgame, he's willing to sacrifice friends, family, and even people working for him to complete his agenda, right? Nothing will get in his way. And my last and final trait is that the villain must be a worthy opponent. This brings me to the classic case of Joker, right? He is the number one nemesis of Batman, and he challenges him, right? So a good worthy opponent should challenge the hero and even make them question their own morale. Think about it. Joker believes that Batman is living a lie because he wears a mask. He's not being his true self. However, Joker says that, you know, he's that chaos in the natural order. If people would just live their natural lives and just do what they want to do, act on every impulse, whether it's to kill, rob, hurt, or just live what they do what they want to do, then that's the true meaning of being free. So he challenges Batman to give up a piece of himself because he says, you're not living your true self. And he's here to liberate chaos. That's his whole point. All right, so those have been my top five traits that make a villain. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for when new videos and new content drops. I have been Joseph. Thank you for watching Fiction Ink Flow. Peace.